Still ahead. Memorial Day marks the unofficial start of summer. And for many of us, that means vacations.
That's what I get for trying to be smart. But before you pack up and you hit the road, we've got some summer travel safety tips that you don't want to miss. Do you lie about comedies? Vacation? No, we'll be right back.
Memorial Day is not just the unofficial start of summer. It's really the unofficial start to the summer travel season. And it's not just Memorial Day. We know how busy it is, Memorial Day, but the summer is going to be busy as well when it comes to travel. So joining us, travel expert Troy Pietenbrink. Once again, good to see you, Troy. Really, this summer, maybe more travelers than in a long time.
Yeah, I mean, this is a great summer to travel. I mean, record low airfares, people have feeling good about the economy. So I think you're going to see a lot of folks hitting the travel circuit.
All right, well, it's a good thing we have you because you can break down some of the things that we need, whether we're a seasoned traveler, just need a brush up, or we're going to take advantage of it this year when we haven't in the past.
I mean, I think it's good reminders because when we're vacationing, oftentimes we get a little lackadaisical with some of these things, but it's good reminders. I think one of the things that I tell folks is research your destination. You know, we spend a lot of time figuring out where we're going to eat and where we're going to stay and what we're going to see and do, but we don't necessarily check things like, you know, crime statistics, where should we maybe stay away from. And as you're traveling overseas, the State Department actually puts updates out. Like, there may be some issues going on, and there may be some neighborhood you want to avoid, things like that. The other thing I always remind folks, 911 is not universal. You have an emergency overseas, 911 ain't going to do you any good. You got to know what the local phone numbers and things like that are. So that's really important.
The other thing that I like that you always stress is when you're traveling, we know if you've traveled, especially if you travel abroad, those travel documents, you always want to check, do I have my passport with me, you know, at this time. But you're saying have two copies, really.
Make copies. Make electronic copies, have them stored on your phone, pictures of them like that, but also have the old-fashioned hard copies because what happens if your phone disappears, you don't have access to the Wi-Fi, those sort of things. So have copies of that. The other thing I recommend folks do is always share your itinerary with somebody who's not traveling with you. You know, somebody at home, a family member, a trusted friend, and then check in with them so they kind of know that you actually are on your trip, that you're safe. And then they have backup copies as well in case there's a problem.
Are you a fan, if you travel abroad, of leaving the passport locked in the hotel safe, or do you keep it on your person the whole time?
Now, it really depends on the country you're visiting, because sometimes you actually do need it for different things. But in general, if you don't need to have something on you, keep it in the hotel.
Okay, this leads into my next question, which was the valuables that you want to travel with.
You know, it's amazing when people travel with things that they value greatly. And I'm like, why are you traveling with this? Why do you need this? Why do you need that fancy watch? Leave the stuff that you don't need at home, and then the stuff that you are traveling with, only take out what you need at the time. Leave the rest securely in your room, in the safe, that sort of thing. So that's another thing that's really important.
All right, and of course, research where you're going, and you can find many places online that'll give other travelers opinions on where to go.
Yeah, absolutely. And the other thing I recommend is if you're traveling abroad, the State Department actually has a program where you can register before your trip, and it's called the STEP program, the Safe Travelers Enrollment Program.
Okay.
step.state.gov. Before you travel, enroll in that. So if there's a problem that happens, a natural disaster, a terrorist issues, things like that, the State Department knows you're there and will immediately get to you first before some of the other folks they don't know about.
Oh, fantastic. All right, so this whole thing, Troy, our theme is keeping safe in the summer holiday travel season. That is the broad spectrum. Now let's go on the individual level. While we're traveling, you brought some products here that can help keep us safe.
Yeah, just real quickly, one of the things you're looking for is your travel bags. They've gotten really secure now. This one is cut-proof. This has a cable that wraps through the cord so somebody can't slash it, pull it off of you. The zippers actually have these extra locks on them, so it actually takes a little bit of time.
So the pickpocketing,
so look for things
we're
like
eliminating.
That. Yeah, exactly. This is one made by Lewis and Clark. I love them. Other things, you know, if you're into an Airbnb or something like that, oftentimes they don't have alarms or extra security. This is a door alarm. You hang this on the back of your door. If somebody starts to open or something, sounds an alarm, scares them away, wakes you up, that sort of thing.
And that you can use this at home, too.
Yeah, you could use it at home, too. Exactly. And really inexpensive. And this company called Travel One, they also make this personal panic alarm. So feeling a little leery about someone lurking around or something like that.
Just walking around with it.
Yeah, and it's really loud. Thank God it's in the plastic.
No, well, that's, you want it to be loud, though, if you're walking through.
You do, because noise in that thing is one of the biggest deterrents for someone. They don't want attention drawn to themselves. So, you know, when you're slightly feeling hesitant or something like that, sound that, and I better safe than sorry.
All right, price range on some of these products?
Oh, this is like $8, $12, the bag's like $30, it's cheap. The other thing I always recommend, cheap luggage lock. People laugh at these things, they're like, oh, well, they're so easy to break off. And I'm like, what thief is going to think about the luggage with a lock versus the luggage without it?
Right, it's the path of least resistance,
exactly.
Right? They want to make it easy.
Exactly.
All right, any idea on some great destinations for us this summer?
I think Mexico is always good. Canada's good. Canada's a big third off sale.
But I feel like everybody says Mexico's so scary.
You know, again, do your research. parts of Mexico are just fine. Puerto Vallarta, even Mexico City has gotten a lower crime rate than Washington, D.C., believe it or not. But there's perceptions about that. Europe has never been cheaper, especially with these low-fare carriers that are out there now, like WOW Airlines, mm-hmm. go through Iceland, that sort of thing. Yeah, it's a pretty good deal.
Fantastic. And Troy always gives great travel tips online as well. Folks want to find you on social media?
I am everywhere at The Gay Traveler. So, there you go. Twitter, Instagram, follow along.
Easy to find. Send me questions if you have them. Thanks, Troy. Always a pleasure.
Thanks,
Safe
Steve.
Travels,
Appreciate
as
it.
Always. Not just this holiday weekend, but throughout the entire summer.
Absolutely.